Nucleus. So nucleus is first one identified by Robert Brown, scientist. After that, based, so this nuclear material is stained by that basic dyes. So this named was is known as that Waldeyer chromatin. This nuclear material stained by basic dyes. So that is known as chromatin by Waldeyer, scientist. So it is that nucleus, generally it is a double membrane like structures. So it is known as the outer membrane, it is known as the inner membrane. So between that outer membrane, inner membrane, this space is known as perinuclear space. Okay, it is known as a perinuclear space. After that, so inside that, okay, nucleus, small spherical shape like structure, nucleolus. So after then, chromatin material is present and nucleoplasm is present. So generally this, at the time of the interphase, so nuclear structure is clearly visible, okay, under that microscope. That's why interphase is ideal phase for study and understanding of nucleus, for study and understanding of the nucleus. So which phase is ideal phase? Interphase is that ideal phase. At the interphase means at the time nucleus is not divided. Okay, so in that interphase, so in that nucleus, generally nucleus having that membrane, this two membrane at some places they are not connected, they are interrupted by that minute pores. These minute pores are formed by fusion of two membranes, nucleopores. They are formed by fusion of two membranes. Okay, function, transport of proteins and RNA from cytoplasm to the nucleoplasm, nucleoplasm to that cytoplasm. Next, outer membrane is extension of that endoplasmic reticulum. So this network like structure extension into the cytoplasm, that endoplasmic reticulum. This endoplasmic reticulum is two types. Which endoplasmic reticulum having the ribosomes, that is known as that RER. Which endoplasmic reticulum they do not having the ribosome, that is known as that SCR. RER means rough endoplasmic reticulum, SCR means smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, after that, inside that nucleoplasm is present. Okay, they having that chromatin material and also that nucleolus. Generally each cell having that one nuclei. So it is at general character of that all living organism, each cell having that one nuclei. But in some living organism they do not having the nucleus, they are known as that mammalian cells of RBC and sieve tube cells. They do not having that cell, so they are that anucleate condition. It means absent of nucleus. Cells are anucleate, it means absent of nucleus. Example, mammalian cells of RBC and also sieve tube cells. Okay, so that is that important point about that nucleus. After that, for example, tapetum cells, they having more than one nuclei, binucleate condition. And some algae, for example, in yellow algae, it's showing of that multinuclear condition. And some fungi, okay, multinuclear condition is present in that rhizopus. Okay, so after that, in the nucleus, so elaborated network proteinaceous filament like structures. So this elaborated network protein filament like structure is known as that chromatin. It is known as the chromatin. This elaborated protein filament like structures is known as that chromatin. So this chromatin is two types. Which chromatin is, after staining, the chromatin is having that more coils and appear dark in color. So that is known as the heterochromatin. So this heterochromatin is genetically inactive condition. So euchromatin, the chromatin is appear light in color and less number of coils. So it is genetically active. Okay, so this chromatin fibers are further coiled and condensed to form that chromosomes. Okay, so each chromosome or each chromatin, first one, each chromatin having that each chromatin having DNA plus histone proteins. DNA plus histone proteins and non-histone proteins and some amount of RNA. Okay, that is known as that chromatin. After that, so inside that nucleoplasm, so it is known as that nucleoplasm. So chromatin present after that small spherical structure, that is known as a nucleolus. So this nucleolus is it is not covered by membrane. It is not covered by membrane. Okay, so generally nucleolus having, so having that only that it is made up of ribosomal RNA. It is involved synthesis of ribosomes. So these ribosomes are generally involved in the protein synthesis. Number of nucleolus is that number is different. It means which cells are actively participate in protein synthesis, they having more nucleolus than that other cells. Okay, that is known as that nucleolus. It is not covered by any membrane, so it is continuous to that nucleoplasm. Okay, so for the transport of that materials. Okay,